There's a line attributed to Mark Andreessen where he says, the best product doesn't always win, but the winning product becomes the best product. It might be a Ben Horowitz line. I don't think it's always true. It's true in the sense that if you're winning, you can get the capital and the talent to retool your product to become the best product in the space. But if the space is fast growing, your team is mediocre, and it's too hard to change the product on the customers, the backwards compatibility makes you put in too many switches, dials, and settings, and makes the product hard to use, then you can get stuck in a local maxima, while a fast-moving competitor who started out with a better product but was losing ends up being the winner. Whether the best product wins or not is highly specific to the situation. Especially when markets are small, you can think a certain product is winning when the market is just getting started. For example, in the iPhone photo space, Hipstamatic was the thing to beat until Instagram came along. It wasn't obvious at all that Instagram was going to win until it suddenly did. Hipstamatic had time to improve. They could have raised money to improve, but they didn't. HipChat was a premier chat product, and they were winning. They should have been able to raise infinite capital if they needed to make the product better. But Slack came along and ate their lunch, and the entire time, HipChat was unable to innovate.